story of Ambrose Small, one of this city's wealthiest and most successful theater men. On this day in 1919, he would close the biggest deal of his life. And shortly afterwards, Ambrose Small would disappear, never to be seen or heard from again. His fortune was untouched. His fortune was intact. But he was gone. And that launched one of this city's most awesome investigations. Ambrose Small was a farm boy, born in 1863 near Alliston, Ontario, moved with his family to Toronto when he was 19. He and his father both found jobs at the Grand Opera House. Ambrose was smart and ambitious, and maybe even ready to cut a few corners. Before long, he was a booker, selecting acts for the theater.
Do you think Toronto is ready for this? I mean, don't you think it's a bit too...
That's exactly why I'm...
Small was gambling that Toronto and the Toronto police were ready for a little Victorian sex. Much of Toronto wasn't, but enough was, and the police let it go. Bare legs, bare arms, daring, outrageous, and wonderfully profitable. Ambrose Small knew what he wanted, and what he wanted, he got.
Well, what do you think, Mr. Small? Didn't I tell you they were great?
Fire them.
Mr. Small?
Fire them.
There were those who said Ambrose cut a few corners from time to time for profit. Some said he fixed horse races and made a lot of money from it. Certainly he played cards for high stakes, and he had the nerve of a burglar.
20,000.
Sometimes he failed, not all that often. In some areas of his life, never.
Okay, girls. Make yourselves comfortable.
Mrs. Ambrose Small, the former Teresa Corman, the model of a proper post-Victorian wife. Wealthy, well-bred, musical, very devout. In that, she couldn't have been less like her husband, the man who profited from scandal, the man who had been raised a Protestant. She was a central pillar of the Toronto Catholic Church, a woman who had been granted a private audience with the Pope. The two of them were oil and water, sugar and salt, absurd opposites. They should have loathed each other on sight. But perhaps Teresa saw in Ambrose qualities of daring and ambition that appealed to her. Certainly Ambrose saw in Teresa quantities of money and respectability that appealed to him. They were married in November 1902. And shortly afterwards...
Well, Mr. Small, the grand is finally yours. Congratulations.
Ambrose's drive and Teresa's money combined to form the foundation of an empire.
As you're going, may I ask you a question?
The grand was the start, the first and finest of the theaters Ambrose Small built up across the country. By 1919, he was the monarch of a Canadian kingdom of bare legs and bare arms and very high profits. But then, in November 1919, Ambrose Small heard a rumor and went to New York City. And when he returned, he made a decision. He would gamble one more time. This time, he would lose both his fortune and his life and become a mystery. Tomorrow night, the secret life of Teresa Small.